Hello, hello. Yeah, you can hear me. Okay. So after this discussion, thanks again, Klaus, Mike, Urs, and Yegor for holding this. I will now introduce you the topic of the upcoming educational program. For the ones who just joined, I'm Miriam Niemeyer, and I'm curating the upcoming educational program. Before I start with this, let's have a look at what we have already been doing at Connections in the last 10 years. Connections was established over 10 years ago. Maybe you have seen this poster, it's in the entrance. Since then, Connections explores the urban development in Ukraine and also promotes new approaches and inputs for urban development in the country. It is also promoting an exchange with experts, what we could also see, or what we can see in the framework of the festival, and brings in expertise from abroad to the country. Here are a set of relevant figures of Connections, to name a few. We have organized 12 international festivals with the one today, 288 public events, 20 workshops, and almost with this year, 350 participants have graduated at educational programs. Connection School, as Yegor just said, was established 5 years ago. The reason for doing this was that we realized after working in the field for some time, there's a need for alternatives to the existing educational offerings in the country. Since then, we ran a series of educational programs. Here you see an overview of the five most important which we had. In all the programs, we were working with the spatial, social, political, and economical conditions in Ukrainian cities of today, and were at the same time introducing contemporary urban development approaches to the country. The projects developed in the framework of our programs, as all of the former participants of Connections programs know, serve as a basis for discussion with city officials, NGO, and business, as well as young professionals, of course. Last autumn, we started another one-year program. Most of you have heard about it maybe yesterday, the Integrated Spatial Development Program, Amalgated Romadas. The results were presented yesterday. The exhibition of it you can find in the entrance hall. In the program, we worked on 30 cases of newly formed Ukrainian municipalities, which is the result of a local government reform in Ukraine. We worked in mixed teams of public servants, spatial practitioners like architects, planners, designers, and researchers. All in all, 210 people were involved in that studio. The studio was conceptualized as a series of five workshops. They all lasted 1 week, and they were held simultaneously in five cities. And after that, we also conducted a series of participatory events to integrate the residents' perspective to the concepts which were developed. After the festival, we will start with the synthesis of what was found or developed until now and presented at the conference in Kiev in September this year. In the last year, Connection School also opened a new chapter and enlarged the working field to Western European cities. The idea behind is to not anymore just research from the outside on Western European cities in the framework of our program, which serve as a reference, but actually explore and work with them in real cases. As the first action, we organized together with the Independent School of the City, you were just seeing Mike here on stage, a spring school which was taking place in March in Rotterdam this year. The spring school had the title borders are for crossing. And we explored in that week how the transfer of people, ideas, goods, finances affects spatial, social, economic and political conditions in a Western European harbor city. In the upcoming year, we will follow this new track of exploring and working with Western European cities. We will work on a specific theme with the title Creating Homes for Tomorrow and explore it in different cultural contexts. So we will travel to four cities around Europe. First, we will go to Amsterdam, then we will go to Zurich, to Helsinki, and in the end, we will come back to Kiev to transfer what we have learned in the cities. The program will be organized as a series of one-week workshops, intense, of course, and in each city we will partner with a local educational institution as well as the city administration. Okay, let's talk about the overall focus of the upcoming program a bit closer. Three things are important for the next year. The connections approach, which we will, of course, also apply to this program. The context of global challenges, because it's the major impact on the development of cities today. The focus theme within the title, Homes for Tomorrow, where we will explore the topic of future residential developments. In the next slides, we are going to look a bit closer at them. The connections approach. You heard already about it in the panel discussions. I will outline it a little bit more. So in every program, we follow a certain set of principles. So we have participants from different professional backgrounds who are working together in teams. And that's what the reason why we do this is because we believe that cities today can be only understood in its complexity when you understand them also from the perspective of another discipline. We always work on concrete projects involving administration and other relevant stakeholders to test in a real-world situation what we found out. We facilitate discourse and experimental critical thinking within our round of participants. And we approach the project strategically, following a certain methodology. So we look always at the context of a project very carefully. We try to identify and integrate the stakeholders and think about the process of developing a project. We also work always in different scales, from the city level to the neighborhood to the level of a concrete building could be, to be able to approach the project in its context. And of course, we are collaborating with international experts. About the context of global challenges, there are a lot of global challenges we are facing today and which are affecting the development of cities worldwide. In the context of creating homes for tomorrow, which is just one aspect on which we will focus in the next year, we consider especially these four important. So, globally competing cities, mobility and migration, urban transformation and ongoing urbanization, and the change of society. The issue of globally competing cities is relevant because of today's cities' need to attract the creative class in order to grow economically. The ongoing digitalization makes know-how more accessible, and by this, the world is becoming more flat. But from another perspective, it is also becoming more spiky, to quote Richard Florida. This results in a situation where we have winner cities and city regions gaining importance in the world by being economic and creative powerhouses, and we have the losers who are not able to attract the creative class and are not gaining from the global shifts. So it is important to understand what makes city attractive and how qualities can be preserved when growing. Another aspect is the topic of global mobility of people. According to the UN, The international migrant numbers have risen by a fifth over 4 years to 280 million in 2018. This growing global transit, whether for business, pleasure or immigration, results in a big challenge for cities. The question is how to organize the increasing of mobility, or how to deal with the ongoing modification of our society becoming more and more multicultural and mobile. Because of the global mobility of people, the attractive cities are undergoing processes of rapid urbanization and transformation, which can lead to residential environments like this, for instance, lacking the qualities of neighborhoods grown over decades. For the winning and growing city regions in Europe, this is a big risk, but also a big chance to improve living conditions and reinvent themselves. So the question is how to create livable environments, what is needed to create an attractive residential environment. Another aspect is the transformation of social structures. The way we live our daily life, as well as the forms of living together, have changed over time and lead to the questions of what buildings or neighborhoods should offer in order to answer the needs of people today, of a changing society. With the aspects I just outlined in the background, let's come back to our focus of the next year, creating new homes for tomorrow. Under this title, we will explore how contemporary living environments should be designed and developed in order to answer the challenges cities are facing today. Within the program, we will explore and work on the following questions. What are the strategies to accommodate growth? How to create better places to live? How to answer the diversifying needs and wishes of inhabitants? And how to create places people identify with. We will start our journey, for which you can get the boarding passes in the entrance hall, with a workshop in Amsterdam, which will take place in the end of October this year. We choose Amsterdam because the city is tackling the issue of affordable housing and spatial segregation and trying to find new concepts to deal with this. Another interesting aspect is that Amsterdam develops strategy to support individual ownership. The next school will be held in Zurich in December this year. We choose Zurich because it is the city with most housing corporations in Europe. So almost 40% of the housing stock in Zurich is actually owned by housing cooperatives. In the last 10 years, the building cooperatives in Zurich became, one can say, the breeding grounds for innovation regarding new concepts for sustainable, inclusive living environments, and also for testing possibilities to integrate future inhabitants into the development of new projects. So in that sense, a participatory approach for a project development. Since the city has limited spatial possibilities for extension because of its geography, it has also developed a set of strategies how to grow within his limits. After Zurich, we will travel in March 2020 to the north of Europe, to Helsinki. We chose Helsinki because the city has similar questions as Kiev regarding its development. On the one hand, because the city had moved all the harbor activities, so in the inner city of Helsinki there used to be big harbor areas, they have moved it to the outside. It could free big areas to transform its center to residential neighborhoods where they really applied principles for sustainable residential neighborhoods. The image which you can see here is approximately 7 years old. I've visited that area 1 month ago and it's almost completely developed now. Another interesting aspect also relevant, I think, for Ukrainian background is Finland's long tradition in building affordable housing with prefabricated elements. In the end of our tour across Europe, we will come back to Kyiv, as I said before, in May next year. We will explore the potentials for Kyiv based on what we have learned in the other cities. We will tackle the question on revaluation of existing residential areas as well as the development of new areas. The last workshop will take place right before the next Connections Festival, where the results of the whole program will be, of course, also presented. So here you see the four cities in which we will work in the next year. We will launch the open call in June, in the June 20th, so in almost 1 month. And if you're interested in the new program, we have a corner just in the front, in the entrance hall, where you can get a boarding pass. And we are, of course, looking forward to your applications and see you at Connections.